Good morning and welcome back to Mountain View Bible Church's online service. Happy Mother's Day, first of all, for all of you out there who are watching who are mothers. Maybe you've had biological children, or you've been an adoptive mom, or you've just poured your life into someone else's life and served as a mentor, a role model, an example to them. I just want to say thank you for the countless hours and the tireless effort that you've put into that task of being a mother. We welcomed recently a new son into our family just a couple of weeks ago, and every day I see how incredible my wife is as a mother in that young boy's life, how many sacrifices she makes, how much sleep she gives up, and what a heart she has for that child's future. She has such tenderness and such love, and on behalf of everyone, I thank you. Thank you, mothers, for the effort that you've given and the love that you've shown. I want to give just a brief announcement before we move into our service. Today's service will look just a little bit different. We're going to have a worship-focused service that is praise and worship music. And so with today's service, there won't be a message that's attached. Starting next week, we'll get back to our series in Genesis called Back to the Beginning, and we'll have a few weeks of finishing that series up together. But for today, we're going to have a praise and worship service and just celebrate God's goodness and remember God's strength and his presence with us through a variety of different songs. And so hopefully that'll be encouraging for you, and you'll have an opportunity to worship God from wherever you're at, your home or elsewhere as you're out and about listening to these services. And starting next week, next Sunday morning, so that'll be the 17th, not today the 10th, but next week on the 17th, we're going to start making some changes to begin the process of reopening things here in Mountain View. Now, we're still following the guidelines that the governor of our state here in Utah has set out, and so things will not be completely back to normal yet, but we will be holding our church service on the 17th here at Mountain View Bible Church. We'll still have different guidelines in place. We'll adhere to the social distancing. We'll have certain rows removed from our church auditorium to keep family groups together, but allow enough space between others to, again, try to help and contain this virus as much as possible. We know things might be slightly different. Some of you won't feel comfortable with returning to church yet. We will still make our services available online. At this point, we haven't started live streaming our services, and so next week's service won't be available on Sunday morning at 10:30, but it will be available as soon thereafter as possible. We'll get the recording edited and put it up on YouTube and our website as possible. If we see over time that live streaming would be a benefit to those of you in our congregation, we may take the steps to get the necessary equipment to do that. Also, initially, we're just starting with our 10:30 church service. Sunday school, we hope to reintroduce in the coming few weeks, but there will be no Sunday school next week at 9:30 for adults or for children. We hope to, again, implement those Sunday school programs as soon as we feel like is possible. We also will not begin our other offerings such as nursery or children's church. We need time to schedule our workers to figure out what we can do to still be respectful and maintain some distance and what our workers are comfortable with. And so that will not begin initially starting next week. We want to try to get those things running as quickly as we can, but also, again, to be respectful of one another. If you don't feel comfortable with attending, we encourage you, again, to feel free to continue to join us from the comfort of your own living rooms. If you wish to wear a mask, should you show up next week to our church service here, in addition to spacing everyone out, please do that. If it makes you comfortable, if it helps to protect you, please feel free to wear those to church as well. Again, we want you to feel comfortable being here, but we also recognize that we need to begin reopening some things. As our state is stepping forward with baby steps, we also are stepping forward with small steps as a church family. We'll keep you up to date as we make further changes if we reintroduce different ministries of the church. Obviously, there are needs to stay connected. We want to remain connected to you even if you're not able to join us again here in person. We want to make sure we stay connected with you and connect you with others, or at least connect you with a conversation over the phone. If you have needs or other things, please let us know. You can leave a message here at our church office. Our phone number is 435-635-3344, or contact us through email, our website, or several other ways.
But we're gonna have a little bit different service today. It's going to be all music. You know, we have those praise nights every once in a while around Thanksgiving time. I figured May's just as good a month as any.
Oh,
but had an awesome idea for this first one. We do the family of God here often, and what I like to do is have you guys just start walking around and saying hi and shaking hands, but we don't do that anymore. So what I think you ought to do is maybe text somebody. Text somebody from church that you haven't talked to, a family member even. Just shoot them a little text, say hi, tell them you love them, and that you're thinking about them. Ask them if there's anything you'd be praying for while this song's going on, and hopefully you get to watch this before they do, because then they'll think, oh man, that's way cool. They just thought of me out of the blue. But then when they watch it, though, they're going to understand that Case reminded them to text you, for you to text them, however that goes. But anyways, we're going to start things off with the family of God, and we are going to just have a normal practice session, and whatever happens, happens. So if you got a vacuum, go ahead and vacuum. If you got dishes to do and breakfast to make, just turn the TV or the computer up, and we're going to sing you a song or two while you get all your chores done. Or if you just want to sing with us, you're more than welcome to. This is Family of God.
Call somebody, tell them that you love them, and you're thinking about them. We're going to keep things rolling.
As we travel this song for a part of the family, family of God.
Last time,
I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the
Amen. Hopefully I don't get our mute groups mixed up like I did last time. The third song, just so that you're aware of, because you guys know how all the cards are on the table with me, I accidentally did that with all our effects muted. So that's our raw voices on that third song on the last video series. And I think everybody sounded pretty good. Sounded pretty good. You guys are going to know this when we start playing it.
Jesus came like a stranger in the night, singing praise.
takes me down and I breathe here no more. His anthem will sound on that eternal shore. Join with the angels in heaven on high, singing praise the Lord.
Oh, so this week, you guys probably noticed, I had a couple of you point out that I had something wrapped around my finger, and thankfully you said it wasn't a distraction to you at all, which makes me wonder if it actually was a distraction. Did you guys see it on the recording?
Was it like lime green?
Yeah, a little bit. Close to that. Yeah. Wasn't a distraction, was it? I mean, it's not like I was waving around in front of everybody.
I was mostly just listening, not watching, so it didn't distract me at all.
That's a proper answer, my friend. That was not rehearsed, by the way.
I knew it was there, so.
Oh, yeah, because you guys were here.
Yeah. Can't give you a valid answer, sorry.
You know, sometimes things get crazy, and we have absolutely no idea why God does what he does. But we know who God is, and because we know who God is, even though we're not skilled to understand why he does what he does, we can have faith that he's going to carry us through it. And whether it's our own mistakes or whether it's just a broken, cursed world we're trying to trudge through, God will bring us through any situation on the other side and bring glory to his name because of it. It's not a green light to go out and make mistakes. Keep that in mind. But if you have, hope is not lost. There's a God who loves you and can make beauty from any pile of ashes that's on this earth that can burn. This is my Savior, my God.
To be my Savior.
This next song is called Jesus. It's by written by a man named Chris Tomlin. Be a little familiar to you.
Water, you speak to the sea, and you
This next one is one of our favorites here at Mountain View. They're all our favorites, right? Bob, do you have, are these, have these been your favorites, Bob?
Yes.
You got two thumbs way up from Bob. This extended worship service is brought to you by River Rocks Musicians Tea. Ask them for it. They'll make you one.
Not sponsored, really.
Yeah, there's no sponsorship here. Feeling that a lot of people are washing their counters right now, and they're washing it to the beat, but they're not quite done yet. You think so? Maybe dish. Do you guys do a dishes? Next time we get together, which is looking like it might be kind of soon, so that would be great. But let me know what you were doing while we were playing these songs, because we'll have a little rolling tab going. No financial bets. So back up off us, guys. Just a friendly. What do they call those bets that are just friendly ones?
Gentleman's
bet? Gentleman's bet. Is that? Are they for a dollar though? Yeah, it's just a dollar. But we don't have a dollar. I'm not doing that. Anyways, this old church choir. You know what's funny about that? I gotta not talk because we got a ton of songs. But we sing this song, and I, like, for the longest time, I was reminded of like those older movies, like. Little House on the Prairie and stuff when they go to the church. Like, that's what I thought of when we played this song, Old Church Choir. But, like, now when we play this song, Old Church Choir, I think about what it was like. Like, was it, like, almost 2 months now?
Yeah.
I go, that's the Old Church Choir that I want back. Hmm. It's coming, church. It's coming. Roll it, Maya. Told you we were having fun.
We're going to try this one a little differently starting out. Okay. So it might not work. It might not work.
It's going to work.
There's revival and it's spreading like a wildfire in my heart. Sunday morning, hallelujah. And it's lasting all week long. Can you hear it? Can you feel it? It's the rhythm of a gospel song. Once you choose it, you can't lose it. There ain't nothing gonna steal my joy. Chainbreaker.
Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your house.
we did the last time we were here together as a church family, we did that song, and I remember it was one of the, I think I even said something. It was just one of the sweetest times we've ever done that song. And then we got the quarantine thing and all that stuff about that virus that's rolling around. And you know, now we sing it again, and it has a lot of different feel to it for me personally, and hopefully for you guys too, because now instead of focusing on the one day in your courts when we're all here together and we're all praising God with one accord, we're in the thousands elsewhere phase. But hopefully it's just like maybe like 714 more, not thousands. But we are in that end of the song, and it's neat to see that there's still hope there. No matter what we're facing, no matter what side of the spectrum we're on, there's still hope. In everything that is true to God and His Word, there's always hope. Such a great thing to think about. Lena's going to lead this song with us. It's called Called Me Higher. So if you feel like you're at the top of the list and there's nothing else God can use you for, pay attention to these words, because God wants to take you somewhere special. He wants to do some amazing things with you.
I could just sit and wait for all your goodness, hope to feel your presence. I could just stay right where I am and hope to feel you, hope to feel something again. I could hold on to who I am and never let you change me from the inside. I could be safe, oh, I could be safe here in your arms and never leave home, never let these walls down. But you have called me higher, you have called me deeper. I will be yours.
Hey, Lyle. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness?
Jesus.
Hey, Angelina. His love is mighty, so much stronger.
Jesus.
Dave, he brings our chaos back into order.
Jesus does.
Who makes the orphan a son and daughter, Maya?
Jesus.
This is amazing grace. Move the coffee table out of the way. We're going to have some fun. Who brings the Listen. I got to start off.
What
I got
practice.
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King of all kings. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. May you would take my place. May you would bear my cross. You lay down your life that I would face it breathing. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
Down your mind, and I would be safe.
It was going so good. It was going so good. We're getting a little tired here. I hope you guys are getting tired too. They've probably paused like 13 times already. You know, you guys, I make fun of myself quite often, and I know that you're not really like that. I honestly don't know if you seriously sat down and went through this whole thing without taking a break. If you did, my hat's, if I had a hat, I'd take it off to you because that's pretty good. But we got a couple more in us. We got, yeah, just a couple more.
Three.
A couple, two, maybe three.
Three.
Maybe.
Three.
Doesn't matter anymore. Softly and tenderly. That's not why you worship leader. You don't even follow him when he says stuff anyways.
No, that's true.
Yeah. That's it, guys. Thanks for joining us on our night of music and praise. Oh, what's that? Do you hear that? Did I hear the words encore? Yeah, I've always wanted.
I thought it was thunder.
I always wanted that to happen to me, where everybody's like, encore, one more song. You know how you do that? I've done that. I've gone to, you go to a concert, you're like, one more song.
One more song.
I mean, everybody leaves, but then they come back. One more song.
Should we leave and come back?
Yeah. I'll plug. We're done. No, I'm just kidding. Let's go. This is Sky Spills Over. Someday soon, Jesus is coming back for his church. And when he does, I can only imagine. I don't know for sure, and no one really does because it hasn't happened yet. But when it does, we'll know. But I think it's going to be kind of like when the Holy Spirit, I talked about this, when he fell and there was that mighty rushing sound. And he just came like a thief in the night. Well, he didn't come like a thief in the night. He just fell on the disciples. But at this point, he will come like a thief in the night. We know that. And take us all up to glory with him. This song talks about what that might be like. Ready? Thank you guys so much for being patient and persevering through this. It ain't easy. That's okay.
Is a rose in the desert, will be bred in the dry. Is a quenching rain in the wings of the gathering cloud. Lift your eyes, look to the horizon now.
Have a great week next week, church. We'll see you on the next one.